Welcome to the online certificate course in soft skill training program organized by IQSE Shri Anand College Pathadi. I, Professor Anita Pause, would like to focus on basic skills required to achieve our goals in life, get selected for new job, sustain the job, and get promoted in the job. During all this process, what one requires are soft skills. Hard skills and soft skills are two important words. Hard skills are your degree, your knowledge, computer literacy. With hard skills, you may get job, but to get success in doing job, you need soft skills. Your personality depends 20% on hard skills and 80% on the soft skills. In this competitive world, both skills are important and you need to develop them both. It is a continuous process because a person must engage in a little self-reflection. It might be tough, but also rewarding. At present, we can see that people are interested in learning soft skills because every company or firm wants their employees to be best at its soft skills. Let's define soft skill in a very simple manner. Soft skill is a term often associated with person's emotional intelligence, the cluster of personality traits that pertain to personality attitude and behavior, abilities, interpersonal skills, managing people, leadership. Number of turns are involved in this definition. One has to work hard on each term to grasp all these skills. Hence, it is a lengthy process. What is importance of soft skills training? You may think, what is need of soft skill development? See, when we are doing job at any place, we have to care about our behavior, communication, decisions, working effectively, and so on. Here, we enlist importance of soft skills. The point first, to handle interpersonal relations. It means one should have good relations with colleagues, other staff, and everyone in general. Second point, to learn to make decisions. One should be always able to make decision whenever necessary. Skipping to decide is wrong. Sometimes you may learn from your mistakes. Third point, to communicate effectively. You should be loud and clear while communicating with anyone. You should be sure that your message is delivered correctly. Next point, to have good impression and impact to gain professional development. Our personality impresses others. So, you need to have proper fashion sense, proper body language, good communication skills, work ethics, ability of listening, dedication, teamwork. Impact of all these things build our personality as well as one can gain professional development. What are most important soft skills? Soft skill development is incredibly slow process as it requires change of personality and habit rather than change in knowledge. Here are some soft skills: communication skills, body language, making decision, self-motivation, leadership skills, team working skills, creativity and problem solving skills, emotional intelligence, adaptability or flexibility, work ethics, time management and ability to work under pressure. If you see you have some of the above skills in your personality and you want to improve other skills too, then question is how to improve them. Let's explore how to improve soft skills with a few simple strategies. First of all, develop learning mindset. You need to have a mindset to learn new things every day. You should be consistent in whatever you do. Next, encourage self-reflection. Always encourage yourself by reading about your idols, by learning new things. Another point is, expand knowledge and understanding. Most important thing is our knowledge and you need to upgrade it every day. Another point, provide opportunities for practice. Provide or seek opportunities in every situation to use what we have learned, because practice makes man perfect. And the last one, ask for feedback. You should be open for criticism by others, and you should work on your negative points and weaknesses. Let us discuss some of the soft skills in short. These skills will help you in improving yourself and performance in interviews also. Let us focus upon communication skills. It is a process through which a message is exchanged from sender to the receiver and vice versa. Communication process will complete once the receiver understands the message of sender. If not, the process will remain incomplete. The proper use of grammar helps in building effective communication. Grammar plays vital role in good communication. Any language can be mastered only after mastering grammar. Always think before you talk. Use simple and short sentences to convey your message. The language should be fluent, as it is an important tool to communicate. We will focus on this point, body language. It is a natural representation which is inbuilt within each and every living organism. It is non-verbal communication. It delivers its meaning with the help of physical movements of our body parts, which comprise of face expression, body posture, gestures, signs, eye contact, hand and feet movements. It aids us when the verbal communication is difficult. It also determines attitude of person during conversation. A positive and effective body language is always necessary to succeed in any part of life. Effectiveness of communication depends on 60% on body language. So remember important facts about body language. Always carry a pleasant smile. Maintain a proper eye contact. While talking to people, always stand up as you look powerful and confident. Always use your arm movements during any kind of explanation which will make you look confident. Always sit your toes pointing out. Avoid hand-to-face movements during any conversation. Don't cover or hide yourself in meeting or group discussion. Avoid folded arms or crossed legs during speaking and listening. Avoid nail biting, scratching head during any confused situation. Avoid grooming gestures when you are in public place. One more important parameter of soft skill is making decisions. As I said earlier, making decision is very important. It does not matter if it is right or wrong. What matters is you decide something. Sometimes the actual decision does not even matter. What matters is that you have made one and move on. Self-motivation. In its simplest form, self-motivation is the force that drives you to achieve the goals, feel more fulfilled, and improve overall quality of our life. It is far from simple. Ability to motivate yourself is an important skill. Self-motivation drives people to keep going even in the face of setbacks, to take up the opportunities, and to show commitment to what they want to achieve. Finally, friends, observe this chart. It differentiates the negative and positive thoughts. It's up to you to think positively and get motivated in your life. Think positive. May positive things happen in your life. Thank you.